Okay, so gearbox out on bench. Take off the top plate. There's nothing very exciting in there. The only time you need that open is to, when it's all back together, is to adjust the stop bolt on the reverse lever. Inside the transfer box, there's a bolt that comes up, stops the reverse going past its gear stops. Right, top plate. Inside here, there are ball bearings and separators that drop into little grooves in the selector shafts that give you that nice positive click when you change gear, and they also stop it wobbling about. So, personally, I took the centre one out first. So you've got the top, a spring, and clean all the crap off the magnet. It hopefully will come out. Yes, there you go, ball bearing, old fashioned, very basic. But it works. Leave that there for a minute. Then you've got the same in the sides, or similar. I'll put that other. Oh, there it is. And these are not the easiest bolts because you can't put a socket on them when two bolts are in. Apologies for being in the way. I'll do it left-handed. So, you've got the retaining bracket, a spring with a seal, which always leaks, and a ball bearing. A lot of people moan about the leaks on old cars, but I like to think of it as an active anti-corrosion system that stops everything underneath rusting. When it's covered in oil, it can't rust. I can't do this left-handed because I've got to hold the bracket. So, bracket off. Seal and spring. It's just reminded me I didn't order them new seals. Oh well. And ball. I love it when a plan comes together. So, nothing's now going to fall out. Front of the selectors, there's two brackets or plates that retain the selector seals in place. They're just rubbers that go over the selector rods, again stop the oil coming out. Again, they're not overly successful. But they do slow it down. Don't order all the same ones because the reverse seal is slightly bigger than the forward seals. Now to remove the top cover. Oh, I'll put that in the nose. Top cover. So you've got two nuts there. And I've just lost a washer. There it is. I know you think I'm stupid, but bagging everything, but it works for me. And these are the two bolts that hold the gear lever on anyway, so they're going to be loose after you've taken it out. That is, unless you've took it out with the gear lever on, in which case it won't look like this, won't it? Right, big reveal. Top cover comes off. And there it is, top of the gearbox exposed. Now you can see what I was talking about there. You've got an extra two spacers, or they're not balls, but they're ball ended. So they drop into these grooves. That's where the top one goes in. So you've got, when it's in, when that one's forward, it goes in the back, and back, it drops in and holds the selector rod solid. Now there is a sequence for getting these out. I can never remember it. Pretty sure it's that one first. I might have to look that up. Or is it the reverse first? I can't remember. We'll reverse out of the way, and that out of the way. I'm sure somebody clever will put a comment in as to which way I'm supposed to do it. So, there's your third and fourth selector. Reasonably sure that's the first one supposed to come out anyway. Which way's the gears go? No, that's the first and second selector. There's your third and fourth selector. And there's your reverse selector. I'll tidy this up, make a bit of room, and then we'll come back to the gearbox. Apologies if it's a bit of shake on the camera, because I've just kicked it. I'm about to jerry-rig it over the bench anyway. Right, special nut, previous builder used a chisel to tighten that up, so I'll put a new one of those on. Locking tag washer that goes behind it. Locking tag seating. And primary drive cog sits on the back. So your locking tag sits in two of those grooves. Well, the locking tag washer goes across two of them grooves, and then your tags go in. As you can see, it's been standing, so all this needs cleaning up. Oil thrower. Exactly as it sounds. That scoops up oil, splashes it round as it spins. Keeps the inside of the box moist. Moist. Don't you think moist is such a good word? It's not used enough, I don't think. Right. To remove. Lay shaft comes out first. Always seems to for me anyway. Front one just doesn't like coming. And that's it in all its glory. Once you've seen that, you worry about some of the speeds you can achieve on Land Rovers. And this is going to embarrass me now and not want to come out. So we'll try and persuade it a little bit first. Gently. Take the needle bearing off and protect that. Well, it's a roller bearing, really. It's needle roller, I think the technical term is for it. Let's see if I can just start the movement. Ah. Okay, so there's your third and fourth synchro. And surprisingly enough, this has actually still got its springs in. That's something to point with. In there, and if you can just see it, there's this piece of spring steel. There's the end of it. It's got a bow shape to it, and that gives that, or centres that when it slides forward. You can see the end of it there a little bit. So that is how your synchro works for third and fourth. Big bag. No. This I do want to keep clean, because it looks in very good condition. Now for the main shaft. Ask it nicely first. No. In that case, there's no circlips or anything on it, so just tease it first a little bit. Okay, why won't the main shaft come out? I might have to look this up and then come back to that. I'll stop it there for a moment. Having consulted the Bible, I was correct. Using a soft face mallet to gently tease the main shaft out of its bearing. And we've got to gently tease it out of its box. Without losing any bits off it. There we go. So all that's left in the gearbox now is the reverse gear. And oh, you can't see, it's too dark. That looks pretty doggy. We might need a new reverse gear, I think. And they're different on suffix B and C engines to the earlier A engine. So that's basically insides of your box. So you've got the lay shaft, you've got the synchro sitting there, drive shaft sits on, primary drive turns that, you move those to select the gears, drives it to the outside. That is your first and second synchro in there. Let's see if I can put this back together and it's right position. That bearing needs to go in there. That synchro is twisted. There we go. Where's that falling off? Yeah, it is. That's it in there. In there. Third and fourth synchro sits on. There, I don't get it on. So remember that overlap. So you've got your primary there, turns that, and then subject to which gear you've selected, then depends which gear on the main shaft is connected to the constant drive, which drives the rear of the gearbox.